Howdy y'all, welcome to Lex Lives. I think it's time to play a little 70s a Die. Man, I'll tell you what. I just logged in. Whatever. Started the game. And, oh crap. There's that slight delay. Uh-oh. Apparently backed right into somebody. Good thing I'm wearing armor. There's a slight delay before you, where you're in the game, but you don't control the game. And, all I could hear was moaning. You can't see anything, right? Because it says building environment or whatever. I'm like, no! Don't let it bite me before I get in! Let's see, I found a map. So we can add that to the list. Alright, and then I gotta take that off the list because this corner right here is where my timer is, and this line right here covers part of the timer, and I can't see what time it is. And I already natter on too long as it is. Quests. All right, I heard someone. Was it you? You guys are making it tough to get over here and start exploring this little crossroads. Okay, so I already dropped a bed last time. I've got my bike there. We've got Days End Suites. I have never seen one of these before. It's like a motel. Cool. This is clearly a motel full of zombies. Not as cool. Hey! There's a fence between us, buddy. You cheater. He's a dirty cheater. Oh, I'm thirsty. Thirsty. Need some water. Oh. There's so many zombies here. I just want to look at these places. Guys, come on. There's a Shotgun Messiah over here I need to search. And we got a whatchamacallit shanty town there. Oh, man, this place is crammed full of zombies. Oops. Totally let that one out. Makes sense, I suppose, that this place would be I kind of want to take those. This place would be crammed full. I'll take those. Oh, you know what? We were grabbing stuff from these guys too. Gotta get those mechanical parts. I think you get it from these too, right? Yeah. Okay, I'm done looking at those. I'm tired of tearing those apart. I hear you, but you're not in here with me, and you don't appear to be coming into the same room with me, so I find I don't care. I just don't care. You make all the noise you want. Oh, look at that. This guy's got a couple of schematics in here. I mean, I don't need schematics, but it's still nice to get the point upgrades. Oh, there's a lot of zombies over here. Ooh, glue. We'll take that. That guy dodged a little bit, just the last second there. Seriously, why are there so many? Ooh, up a level. What are you doing, guy? Yeah, terrible aim. Terrible aim. All right, that water's polluted. I wonder if this water's polluted. I'm afraid to get in there and not be able to get back out. Okay, this door's partially busted. Nobody's in here, though. Okay. We're good, we're good. So let's see. I start a new book series this week. Although, they're really tiny. So here's the thing. I like huge stories. I don't mind if they come in small parts. I am. Did I go through that back door? I did. Okay. I'm a fast reader, I guess. And one of the things that I have noticed is that Amazon has got this new thing where people can publish their books, right? And I've read quite a few good books on there. The problem is that the books they publish are teeny tiny books. And so everything is like rushed. And they're not big, long, epic stories. I don't know if that's a problem. That's what it feels like to me. So, the book series, I lose air quotes, see, book series, I'm reading now is pretty good. It's Behemoth. Once again, military science fiction, because that's my kick for the last couple years here. I feel like I want to switch back to fantasy, but I haven't come across a book that made me want to jump over yet. I mean, into this year, obviously, with the new Sanderson book coming out at the end of the year in about November, I will be switching to fantasy because I love that guy. He's my favorite author. And okay, I'm tired of searching this place. I guess it's just more of the same, right? Every room. Sure, there might be some good stuff in here, but I don't feel like there's gonna be anything. Wow, this place is huge. Really amazing. I'm really surprised at how big this place is. Ooh, I'm gonna jump down here. Ugh. Okay, let's go over here to the gun store. So I've like already torn through three of the four books that are in the series. In like, I did two of them last night. They're that short. I was feeling really tired, and so I went to bed early. And then, as soon as I get in bed, of course, then I'm not tired, because that's the way it works. And so I started reading, and I just went ahead and read right up until my normal scheduled bedtime, which meant that I burned through a little over two books in the series of four. Once again, they're more like novellas, I guess, than actual. I don't know why I just used my axe to hack through that metal. Guy? Are you okay there? With your head sticking through? You're like one of those battery-operated heads you mount on the wall that just do silly things. That's funny. All right, what we got? I'll take it. It's a nearly 600 pistol barrel, all right. Ooh, I'll take that. Probably. I better take that too. I'm not sure what parts I still need for my AK. I know I still need some parts for it, but I just don't remember which ones. Yep. I should probably think about looting these for water. Done. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty good. I feel like it's the second series, but everything I looked at said it was the first series, and they keep referencing a previous invasion, but they don't give you any information about the previous invasion, really. Other than, like at one point they talk about how the humans fought off the previous invasion, but then another spot they talk about how, the alien alliance the humans are trying to join helps fight off the invasion. And so I'm like, okay, well, which one of these is true? Did the humans do it or did the aliens do it? You can't really have it both ways, can you? Yeah, it's pretty good. If they were longer, I would rate it higher, honestly. I really like the last series I read. What are you doing? Weirdo. The last series I read, I really enjoyed those, and they were longer, but I don't think they were as good as these books, other than being longer, which doesn't necessarily make you better, as in this case. And I really, really like these current books, and the author seems to be pretty good. I just wish he wrote bigger books. But then again, I think there's four books out. I don't know that they can end this story in four books, so. That totally says the door's unlocked. I'm still sitting here. Okay, I need. Thanks, chair. Hey, guy, what happened to your legs? Hey, how did you hit me? Why won't you die? Sheesh. Seriously, what happened to that guy's legs? Yeah, I can't pick up those mines. I don't know what the deal is. I tried. All I wind up doing is exploding them. So now I just blow them up from a distance. Try and keep me safe. Oh, look at all those guns. It's alright, they're only mediocre guns. You know what? I think that is this place, right? I can't think of anything else that I need to search here. There wasn't anything over here, so. I guess we continue on to the south, maybe? So let me... Oh, you know what? Where's that treasure? How far away is that? Oh, look, the treasure is actually over there. Let's head toward the treasure. What is wrong with the animals in this game today? That chicken is also crazy. Okay, we gotta be careful and try really hard not to drive into the water. I know that's difficult for me, but I'm gonna try really hard. But yeah, so I mean, like the book opens up talking about how they rebuilt the behemoth, and but they don't ever say what happened to the behemoth. I don't know what's up with these guys, like, dropping you in the middle of the story without giving you a flashback to what happened before. I mean, it's okay to drop you in the middle of the story, but eventually you gotta tell me what happened in these things you're referencing. It's like the books by Arsenault. I don't know the name of the... John Walker, actually, I believe is the name of the author I'm reading now. But Stephen Arsenault, he went through whole books without giving his character a name. Which I get that you're first person, but come on, somebody's got to call her by her name. I honestly did not learn her name until the sixth book of the sequel series. I mean, it may have been in there before that, but I didn't notice it until the sixth book of the sequel series. Okay. Let's back you up, because I definitely don't want you. Over the area I'm about to dig up. You're dead. I did bring a shovel, yes? Nope. Yes, I did. It's in the bike. Mm-hmm. Oh, I heard you coming. Oh, I'm gonna die. No, 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 no. Don't kill me. Oh, shoot. Don't step on that. Come on. Oh, no! Dang you, game! That is the game's fault. That is the game's fault. I clicked on that stupid bandage 3 times and it wouldn't select. In fact, 1 time it moved. Day one, I've awoken in the desert. I'm naked. I don't know how I got here. I don't know how far it is to the nearest. Oh, they actually started me not too far from my stuff, strangely. Dang it, game. When I click on something, you need to select it. I don't know what this hesitation is. There's only a couple of games it happens in. And it's mostly this one. You know, I'd almost think it's my mouse, except that no. I'm pretty sure it's just this one. This is the only game. I was thinking for a second there. I was thinking for a second there. It might happen to be an Ark as well. But that's it. Just those two. Seriously? Oh. Sometimes I hate the dogs in this game. I also hate that grass blocks your punches. Like, I'd have had three more hits on that dog if the grass hadn't have blocked my punches. Well, at least we got the treasure chest to tell me where my stuff is. But anyways, so back to the book, provided I can ever get to my stuff. It's pretty good. It's got some really good moments in it and some great quotes. Honestly, if the book was a little longer than like an hour and a half for me to read through, you know, I would have rated it higher. But they're too short. I mean, I went to bed like at, I want to say 11:30 last night. I was in bed. And I don't normally go to sleep until about 2:30. And so I just laid in bed and read books. I guess sometimes you need a recharge. In fact, not only was I tired when I went to bed last night and then couldn't sleep, today when the alarm went off, I shut the alarm off and went back to sleep for another hour. Although, you know, I do have this stupid cold. Oh, good. Oh, it's a deer. I was gonna say, here comes the dog again to tear me up. Although, knock on wood, I did not wake up having a coughing fit last night for the first time in multiple days. I'm still coughing. Oh, I was sure it was gonna kill me. I just am not. Didn't wake up from it, so. But yeah. In fact, I need to cough right now. That zombie's too close. Ugh. The book. Some aliens attacked Earth at some point in the past. I don't know. And apparently there was a ship called the Behemoth. I don't know. It's not in the book. And the aliens helped the humans rebuild it, and so now they've got the first Behemoth. Or the new Behemoth is ready to go. Still in dock, but ready to go. And they detect something coming in the outer edge of the solar system. Which they have blanketed because of readings they took during the aforementioned battle that is not in the books. And I have no idea why readings taken during that battle would have you build sensors along the edge of the solar system, but whatever. And So, in the first book, it's a an alien ship of unknown design who apparently, now here's the weird part. At no point in that book do they say that the people attacking the aliens are the same people that attacked Earth. Like this alien ship comes in, everybody on board is in cryo sleep. They're the last of their people. They fled from, man, they fled from someone who blew up their planet. At no point in that book do they say that the aliens that show up chasing them are the same aliens that attacked Earth. At no point in there. And so it's very weird when you're reading it because the aliens they rescue off of that ship have got that's a pig. What's gonna happen now is I'm gonna hit a landmine, right? And it's gonna blow me up. Oh crap. No. Bad dog. Go away, dog. Go away. Why'd you chasing that pig? All right, now where am I? And then I think the second book they send the oh, maybe I only read two books last night and I'm on the third book. I was thinking I read book three last night, but I'm on the start of three. So in the first book is the alien ship shows up that may or may not be being attacked by the same people that attacked Earth, and some of it's really good, and some of it's just like I don't think it could work that way. One of the things I noticed in these small books that I've been reading is that I kind of gloss over technical issues that would occur and just let their people succeed in things that there's not really a way to be able to do it. Like, they meet the aliens, right? And the aliens, they're on the alien ship, and the alien ship's been damaged. And luckily for them, not only do the aliens use the same computer system. or a similar computer system to humans, and so they're able to patch in almost immediately. But the AI on board has learned the English language from scanning the behemoth and now speaks English. Which I suppose technically could be possible if the AI was capable of matching a, I don't know why this would be on the behemoth, but capable of matching a symbols to sounds, and found some kind of child's reader primer. Because there's a book I read, and it pointed out the fact that if you do not have common things, you can't learn another language. Language is a verbal and pictorial representation of real world concepts and objects. And so, even amongst those concepts and objects, we have different things. So, when I say the word home, what you imagine in your head as the image of home is different than the image that I imagine in my head of home. So, even though we understand the same concept, our idea of the concept of home are slightly different. But potentially, we're both human. I mean, I don't know. Maybe aliens are listening in. I don't know. And so, you can't look at alien writing and decipher it because you don't know what those correspond to. You just don't. Unless you've got like a child's primer that shows you a picture of an object that you could recognize. And the words that go with it, and if it happens to have audio, the audio that goes with that, then you could decipher it. But if you just come across writing, you can't. You just can't. There isn't a way. That's how come we can't. That's how come we don't have a perfect translation of things like the hieroglyphs in the Egyptian pyramids. Or, I guess there aren't hieroglyphs in the pyramids, but the hieroglyphs on the buildings near the pyramids. It's because nobody speaks hieroglyph. Nobody. There's nobody left on the planet that speaks hieroglyph. They were wiped out, killed specifically because they spoke or read the hieroglyphic language. The only reason we know what we know, I mean, there's been a lot of work trying to figure out how to decipher them, but they still argue over the definitions of things because they don't know. They guess, and they're pretty sure, but pretty sure isn't fact. And so they still debate what the hieroglyphs could mean. And we only know what we know because someone accidentally found a stone while building a wall to protect him from gunfire during the Napoleonic Wars. I mean, that's crazy. I just. And that's an English language. Or not an English language, I'm sorry. That's a human language, I mean. A human language, and we couldn't decipher it. And the human language refers to things that we understand, and we still can't translate it. Well, how the heck are you going to translate something from an alien species that might not think the same way as humans? So they just ignore all that. In fact, I think the Arsinoe books, they've got a universal translator that just basically, after it talks to another person, just talks to them. Can figure out the language, which is just bizarre to me because without some kind of primer book, or it doesn't have to be a book, but you're not gonna get it. It doesn't happen. You have to have examples that relate to things you understand. And so then like it's just a matter of seconds, and then they're like, oh well, Universal translators picked up on all of it. Now we understand every word they're gonna make. I've seen some that get by that by going like telepathic, which could work because then you're speaking in concepts and not structural language. Yeah, I don't know. It just they really gloss over like, oh, look, our computer plugs directly into this computer and is able to. I can hack the enemy software. No. How could you rewrite the enemy software when you don't speak their language? Okay, somewhere here I parked a bike. And I died. Ow. Well, my bike's missing. And I have no idea where my stuff is at. This is so weird. Now, I'll grant you my stuff is around here somewhere because I stepped on a cactus and then I died and I was running away from a zombie. So I'm not exactly sure where that was at. But why can't I see my bike? Which I parked. Oh, right here. I can't see it because I'm blind. And now I don't remember where I ran to. This is gonna be like that time that I lost my bike. And I had to go back and watch the video to find it. I'm gonna have to go back and watch the video to figure out where I left my stuff. All right. Well, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So click like if you like, subscribe if you're sure, and catch the next one. I will talk to you later. Thank you.